Hey there, super scientist! Today, we're going to be investigating the wonderful world of motion. But first, I have a little experiment that I'm working on. Can I move this toy car with just my mind? Let's find out. Okay, hold on, let me try that again. Doesn't seem to be working. But if I can't make this car move with my mind, and it can't move by itself, what causes this car to move? Motion is when something changes position or moves from one place to another. As I walk over here, I am in motion because my position is changing. When I freeze, I am not in motion. When something is in motion, it means it's moving. So, how do I put my toy car in motion? In order for something to be in motion, a force needs to act on it. Force is a new word, but it means something really simple. A force is a push or a pull. Forces are what cause motion. For example, when you kick a soccer ball, you are pushing it with your foot. When you're playing tug of war, you are pulling on the rope with your arms. Let's give it a try with my toy car. If I apply a force on the car by giving it a little push, there it goes. When I pushed the car, it moved forward. When I pull it this way, it moves backwards. I'm gonna push it again. And this time, I want you to watch closely and observe the way the car moves. Imagine the car's wheels left marks on the table. What type of line would it leave behind? Exactly. When I pushed the car, it moved in a straight line. There are other objects that move in a straight line too, like trains. Objects can also move in an up and down motion, like a seesaw. Some objects move in a zigzag motion, like a slithering snake. Some move back and forth, like a swing. Other objects move round and round, like a carousel. All of these types of motion are caused by forces pushing and pulling in different directions. Pause the video here and observe your learning environment. Look around carefully for anything in motion. Maybe you see a tree branch outside moving back and forth in the breeze. Maybe you see the hand of a clock going round and round. Or maybe you see a mosquito in the air flying in a zigzag motion. Motion is all around us. While you were searching for objects in motion, I had a brilliant idea. Over here. Now that I've learned that I can move my toy car with just a little push, I thought I would try to move this car too. Pretty impressive, huh? I know what you might be thinking. There's no way I can move this car, but remember, we learned that all an object needs is force to be put in motion. That means I can push or pull this car to make it move. Easy peasy. Okay, let me try pulling it. Okay, this is proving to be more challenging than I thought. Let's go back to the classroom. We know that we need to use force, like a push or a pull, to move an object. When I push my toy car, it moves, but when I push my real car, it doesn't move. How could that be? Oh, hey Mia. You think you can help us answer our question? Oh, that makes sense. the heavier an object is, the more force it requires. Let's try that out. Thanks, Mia. To test this, we're going to investigate three objects to see if they need a lot of force to move or only a little bit. The first object is a feather. Do you think this object needs a lot of force or only a little bit of force to move? That's right. I can use a very small amount of force to move this feather. Watch. The feather is so light that I barely needed any force to put it in motion. Next up, we have this boulder. Do you think this object needs a lot of force or only a little bit of force to move it? That's right. This boulder needs a lot of force. More force than I can muster. No matter how hard I push, I cannot move this giant rock. Yet. What about this stack of books? Do you think this stack of books needs a lot of force or a little bit of force to move? Good job. Even though these books are heavier than the feather, I am still able to move them with a push or a pull. Great job, scientist. After all that investigating, I think we're ready to answer our question. How do things move? We learned that objects need a force, like a push or a pull, to make them move. Thanks to Mia, we also learned that the heavier an object is, the more force it needs to put it in motion. Be on the lookout for objects in motion around you. Try to investigate the forces pushing or pulling them into motion. Remember, science is all around us. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.